Obama and the last Congress passed about $800 billion in stimulus spending to boost the economy and create jobs.
And a lot of that money came right here to the tri-state. You've probably seen the signs. But what did we get for that investment? Well, NewsOne's Amy Wagner spent weeks, the last several weeks, tracking the spending and showing us what she found. Good evening, Amy.
Hi, Sheree. Well, the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act brought $65 million in road projects to Hamilton, Warren, Butler, and Claremont counties with the main goal of putting America to work. But what I uncovered was a far different story.
I never really saw an impact. I never saw any of the money or anything. Nothing's ever come our way.
We began a month-long investigation, digging into the millions of dollars that flowed into the tri-state. According to ODOT records, that $65 million either created or saved about 627 jobs. A closer look showed that's not really the case. Here's why.
It had to be a shovel-ready project.
And for the most part, that meant paving projects. Two companies came away with nearly 70% of the stimulus money that came here. J.R. Jurgensen made nearly $23 million from ARRA funding, while Barrett Paving made $21 million. And more shocking, neither company hired a single employee with the money.
It's rough. It really is.
We repeatedly asked both companies for an on-camera interview. Both declined. In a statement, Jurgensen's human resources director said, quote, "The money didn't create new jobs, but kept people from losing them." When pressed about how many jobs were kept, he said, quote, "Had we not had the ARRA projects, some paving crews might not have been recalled." As for Barrett, the story is similar. The vice president for the Midwest said, quote, "The good thing about the stimulus money, we retain jobs. Without it, we would have been impacted tremendously." But Jeff Lamb couldn't say whether those jobs that have been saved will still be there this spring when construction season starts up again. And while both companies claim the money did make a difference, Dave Carpenter digs in and disagrees.
I say they're wrong. This money's done absolutely nothing. If it has, it's done it for somebody I know nothing about.
And tonight, our investigation continues. I went directly to the man in charge to try to figure out how many jobs were really created. Vice President Joe Biden has said for years that when it comes to the stimulus money, the buck stops at his office. But instead of answering our questions, his office referred us to the Department of Transportation. They ignored my interview request. So I went down another layer to the Ohio Department of Transportation. The folks in charge there sent me down to ODOT's District 8 chief, who in turn stepped aside and let the local spokeswoman handle our questions.
These projects kept people working. So they did give people a paycheck to pay bills, buy cars, take care of the families.
And don't worry, we intend to keep pushing for more answers and digging into where this money went and why those new jobs didn't necessarily follow. And in the meantime, you can see the list of those projects and the jobs they promised on WLWT.com. And of course, there's still so much more digging to be done here. While we know what happened with those two companies, there's several smaller contractors that did get a little piece of the money, the ones that I was able to contact. Still the same story, no new jobs. And I think that's sort of the amazing thing in all of this is all this money, very few jobs. Right.